This coming Tuesday will mark 17 years since the terrorists killed thousands in New York, D.C., and Pennsylvania. But many of those who survived the attacks of 9/11 are still suffering the effects. Thousands are now fighting cancer and other illnesses after inhaling all of that toxic dust for more than a month at Ground Zero. There are programs which offer help and compensation to first responders and survivors, but some of those who need the help are not getting it. John Stewart, John Feel, and Richard Alice have spent years fighting to help 9/11 survivors. And I spoke with them earlier this week.
Thanks for having us, man.
Why are you here? In case someone's forgotten.
I'm muscle. I'm with these guys. If anybody tries to get in their way, I start throwing fists.
Actually, of course, back in the day, you were one of the ones who did a lot of the pushing to get this legislation in place. And now some of that legislation's about
right.
to run out.
That's correct. So these guys have been working on this since 2004, and they've been the boots on the ground. John has been to Congress hundreds of times.
Hundreds.
257 times.
Walking the halls. Not that he's counting. And Richard as well. And so as the VCF, which was only funded for 5 years, comes up in 2020, we're just trying to get ahead of it a little bit to let people know that there's still time to sign up for the program. There's still thousands of people. Even this morning, we were at a news show. There were some cops that were down there that were working the show, and they go, you know, we were down at the pile, too, not signed up for the program. So getting the word out that this program is out there, that you can still sign up, and trying to get Congress aware that this thing has to get renewed before 2020, before the VCF runs out of money.
Well, it will run out of money.
Absolutely.
Right.
John, what happens if it runs out of money?
Well, if it runs out of money and we don't get the bill extended, then those who get sick after that, they'll get the free health care under the World Trade Center Health Program, but they won't get compensated for their illnesses. This struggle, this fight, this pain and suffering is real. We average losing somebody every 2.7 days. We lost somebody this morning, a 46-year-old United States Marshal, to 9/11 related cancer. You know, let's go back in time, Shep. When John did his show in 2010, you followed up the following day. And it truly helped us get a bill passed that saved tens of thousands of lives.
Why did that help?
Why did that help?
Are you familiar with the word shame?
Well, you know, and
who was fighting against this?
Oh, wow.
We are apolitical. We don't care what your affiliation is. We just care that you do the right thing. And there are people from every state. 433 congressional districts were represented at Ground Zero during the cleanup and the recovery. Many of these men and women, close to 100,000, are now in the World Trade Center Health Program across the country. 40% have more than two illnesses. The struggle's real. The fight's real. We need to get this bill extended and add more money to it so that these men and women, uniform or non-uniform, but going back to what you said, when he did his show and you followed up the next day, it was a snowball effect between the boots on the ground and you guys doing your shows. It helped us get to the finish line and save a lot of lives. And we can joke about it, and we can look back about it, a Democrat and a Republican, but at the end of the day, you saved Americans' lives. And at the end of the day, Richie and myself, we don't care who helps us as long as they help us.
Mm. And it's not as if people are asking for things that they don't deserve or that haven't already been put into place, Richard. It's just that for some reason, this bill was a temporary thing. Why was it temporary?
The Victims Compensation Fund, which has a short time frame and is probably going to run out of money even before the end of 2020 at this current rate with the number of people that are coming down with these horrendous cancers. And we're talking cancers on steroids. And we, as John so aptly said, that we are trying to be ahead of the curve before we have to bring sick and dying down to Washington as we did the last time. And we can't bring the same people down because they're no longer with us. We have a whole new crop of people that we're going to have to drag down to Washington. We'd really like to avoid that pain and suffering for everyone involved.
There's over 10,000 people now with a certified 9/11 related cancer. Mm. The government says, yes, 9/11 caused your cancer. We're going to outnumber those who died on 9/11 because of senseless violence by the 20-year anniversary. Again, this is real. This isn't us making this up. Like many members of Congress told us, we were fabricating our illnesses. I've been to 181 funerals. And we have to go back and fight again because we have elected officials in D.C. who would rather see each other lose than the American people win.
John, there was journalists go all over the world. We cover wars, cover all kinds of things, and everything seems to have a smell. 9/11 had a smell onto its own. If you were in New York and you smelled that smell, if you were here and you smelled it, you need to get tested, not so that you can get money, not so you can do anything for you, but because of a database that's really important.
If it hadn't been for the FDNY, I think, you know, they were instrumental in us being able to prove the link to 9/11 cancers, because the FDNY had a database for all of their members prior to 9/11.
Of what they were coming down with.
That's right. And so they were able to take that and compare it to post 9/11, what the health issues were, and they could see the deviations. Mm-hmm. And that was instrumental. I mean, you were seeing 25-year-old guys come down with sarcoidosis. You were seeing people, our friend Ray Pfeiffer, having kidney cancers and nose cancers, like things that were anomalies for not only the age population, but the only thing that was sort of close to what it could be were the burn pits in Iraq and Afghanistan and the types of health problems that would come up for that. There's people dying from the attack of 9/11. For them, it's never ended. For first responders, for veterans, for trade unions that were down there, for survivors, for volunteers, there's still like a ticking time bomb inside them. And mesotheliomas and other respiratory illnesses have yet to gestate. Like, we just want to make sure that this stays at the fore so that these individuals can get the care that they need, in many cases that they earned, and that they're not forgotten.
When the Zadroga bill was introduced, that's the bill that back in 2010 made the funding possible. There was resistance to it, which a lot of us here in New York weren't even aware was happening.
Right.
And we couldn't imagine who from New York or who from America could be against funding for people who were victims of this attack. And it turned out there were a lot of them, and a lot of them were playing politics by doing add-ons to bills. In other words, you've got this bill to keep first responders going or to keep any victim from there going, and they would tack on other matters, abortion or whatever it was.
Import-export tax. In 2015, it was they tried to take the money that could have come out of the transportation bill, and they were holding the Zadroga bill hostage to an import-export bill on you know, oil.
Thankfully, it got through.
Yes.
But do you foresee any of those problems this time? Because, for instance, if one of your representatives in Congress or in the Senate or whoever it is who has to do the voting here, the no's, we'll be writing those down and telling you about them eventually. I promise that. But who has expressed opposition, John? Who has said, I can't be for this and why? Anyone?
Sure. I mean, leadership on the Republican Party has always been against this.
And why?
The money.
You know,
in the beginning when we were walking the halls in 2004 and 5 and 6, they said it was a New York issue. Then we showed them it was a national issue. Then they said, well, how are you going to pay for it? And that's like the oldest trick in the book. If they want to find money, they find money. Science caught up to Richie and myself and others who walked the halls of Congress because we knew this was going to happen. We said this was happening. The absorption through the nose, mouth, and skin. We ate there. We slept there. We cried there. We went to the bathroom there. We got sick because we went to the rush and to protect our city and nation. And every September 11th, all of these elected officials who are still in office from when we've been fighting since 2004, they come out and they say, we'll never forget 9/11. We'll always remember our heroes. That's BS.
You know, Richie and John and I and everyone else from down there, we'll never forget roaming the halls with our good friend Ray Pfeiffer, who had stage 4 cancer and spent his last weeks fighting for his brothers and sisters to get this passed, because that's the type of person that he was and that's the type of courage. But man, I hope we never have to waste someone else's precious time that they could have with their families on that type of thing. It should no longer be that these guys have the burden of proof to their own government about what has happened to them. They were told down there the air was safe. Clearly it wasn't. And so, you know, in honor of him, these guys will never stop fighting, and in honor of everybody else. But can't we make this time finally give them some peace? That's all.